So yesterday, what selenium RC is, so we saw that it is one of the components of selenium, and it came into picture just to put a logic in the selenium, because before we have selenium ID, so selenium RC came into picture so that through our coding, through our code, we can put a logic and put some meaningful information in our project and do some dynamic automation, can so that we can handle dynamic applications. Okay, then we saw like to interact with a browser, there is an intermediate person called Selenium server who actually actually interacts with the server, and server actually passes whole data in form of a JavaScript to the browser, and in same way the browser sends an acknowledgement to the server and server sends back to RC. And in what form the communication is done? The communication is done in form of HTTP protocol. Okay. Then we saw Selenium RC was called Selenium 1, and the advantage of Selenium RC when it came, it was like it was supporting multiple operating system, multiple languages and browser. Okay, so we saw that, okay, these are the four components of Selenium RC. So we'll go through each of the components. Once it will be completed, the picture will be clear to us how exactly and internally how actually this RC is working. Like if you write a code, you won't come to know what is happening at the backside. Okay. Once you'll understand the architecture, so when at that time when you will write a code, you have a picture in your mind. Okay, when I am clicking running my program, what will be happening at the back end? So Selenium RC was actually Selenium RC server is there who is actually interacting with the browser, and we are doing the communication through HTTP protocol. So the language what Selenium RC, whatever commands we say write it in the Selenium RC, whatever commands it has, whatever methods it has, is called Selenese. Okay, if you go for an interview or someone asks, what is Selenese? Can you tell me what Selenese commands are? So if anyone is telling you and asking you that what is Selenese, it means these are the Selenium commands used in Selenium RC. Okay, friends? So we'll start with the first component, Selenium RC web server. So let's understand this diagram quickly. So yes, we saw that we have the test cases, and those test cases can be written in any of the programming languages. So once it is written, I'll run my program. So that before I run this program, I need to run my server. Okay. So once my server is running, then I'll click on run. So once my Selenium RC program will run, it will look for the server wherever it is running. It will find the server and send all its request. Okay, so the request, it's not one by one, it's a bunch of requests. All test cases will go all together to the server, and server will be the only person who will be actually communicating to the application under test. Okay, and server will send the request in form of Selenium core, which is a JavaScript. Okay, so Selenium server actually interacts with the browser and sends its request in form of JavaScript, which is called Selenium core. Okay, friends? And what Selenium server will do, like yesterday we were discussing that there was a problem, like two domains cannot communicate with each other. Single domain, single domain communication. Let me check, even I am also getting. Can anyone ping me? What was that problem? I always get confused with that name. Single origin policy. None of you are pinging me. Actually, 2-3 policies are there. Single host origin policy. That's good, Venkatesh. Okay, thanks, Venkatesh. So single host origin policy was the problem that two domains cannot communicate with each other. Okay, so just to overcome that scenario, okay, if you cannot communicate, if you cannot work on two different domains, then what is the use of automation? It will be restricted. It's things will be restricted to one location. You cannot move to a different location, or you cannot work on a broader or a bigger app project or an application. Because once you do an automation, you need to interact with many applications to get the data from and continue. So what Selenium server does, it launches an isolated web server. Okay, so it won't be an actual go live web server. It will be like a local web server. Okay, and on that web server, it will launch the browser and execution will be done on that browser. Okay, so once I'll click my run, it will communicate to the server. What this server will do, before it will send these requests, it will first launch a web server and it will launch a browser on which the testing should be done. Your application will run. So it will be launching two browsers. Even you can launch server and browser together also by configuring your server. You can tell your server that I wanted to have my web server and browser together, but that will give you a problem. It gives a problem when we'll be doing automation of web applications in those cases where applications are built on frames. Okay, so you'll come to know what was the problem if we launch both the things in a single browser. Okay, so it will be an isolated web browser where actually your application will be running. Then what this Selenium server will be doing, it actually launches your browser and the server, and it injects the request in it. And what that request is called? Selenium core. That is a JavaScript. Okay, this slide is clear. Anyone is having any question, just let me know. Okay, I'll move to the next slide. So we saw what Selenium server is. It is actually an intermediate person between you and your browser. Okay, so it is the one that who actually launches and kills the browser. Okay, and then it injects your request in form of Selenium core into the browser. That is a JavaScript. It's the same thing. It also passes the Selenium command. So these Selenium commands are actually Selenium core, which like your Selenium commands are like type Venkatesh, type password admin, and then click on OK. So this was your request. These were Selenium commands, which has been converted in form of a Selenium core and sent to the browser. So what I told you, friends, Selenium core is what? It's a JavaScript. And in what form the communication is done? The communication is done in form of HTTP. Then the second component came. What we had very good with Selenium server, because we have discussed a lot on it. Is Selenium core is Selenies? No, Venkatesh, it is a collection of your request. It's a collection of requests which you want to do in form of JavaScript so that your browser can understand and do the things fast, because browser works quickly. If your request is in form of JavaScript, your execution will be fast. This is how it was built. Thanks, Venkatesh. So what is our next component? Selenium client library. Client library is a very basic thing. Client library is a language which you will be using to write your Selenium code. Your client library can be a Java library, it can be a C# library, it can be a Python, Perl, Ruby. Okay, and like if I'll go to Selenium official website, Selenium download, you can see a list of client libraries, right? These are the client libraries: Java, C#, Python, Perl. So you will be downloading these client libraries so that you can form your request and will be sending it to the server, and then server will be converting your request in form of JavaScript and it will inject it in the browser. Okay, so let me do one thing so that picture should always be clear in your mind. I'll draw a diagram so that it should always be easy for you to. You guys can take a screenshot once I'm done. Okay, so So this is your client library, and then he is your server to whom you are sending the request, RC server, and then this is your browser. Okay, so your client library can be in what? It can be a Java, Python, Perl, etc. These collection of these commands is called Selenis. Okay, this request, we'll be sending this request to server in form of what? Selenis, which is called Selenium commands, and Selenium commands can be in form of a Java command or a Python or a Perl, but it is a Selenium command. Okay, those are called Selenis. You will send it to server. What this server will do, it will collect all your information, all your requests, and will send it to browser in form of Selenium core, which is a JavaScript. So it's a collection of request. Okay, once your request is done, once your process is done, browser will send an acknowledgement to server, server will send an acknowledgement to client library, where it means your the client which is actually running. So it's you who is actually using the client library to run your to do your job. Okay, so that's the reason I have put you in black, because this is something related to Selenium and this is something end user is doing. Okay, so you can take a screenshot of this diagram. This gives you a clear picture what exactly it is. Okay, I'll change the screen. You guys have, okay, I'll give you 5 seconds. Just take the screenshot of this diagram. Done. So, okay, thanks, Shovan. Okay, so we saw what, right now the picture is clear what client library is. So it gives, actually it gives you, provides you an interface between your programming language and server. Okay, you know your programming language and you have your server. Now you want to communicate to your server so that you can send your request. So you can use any of the client library to go ahead. Then now what Selenium core is, this diagram, what it tells that whatever request you have sent it to the server is actually getting collected all together in form of a JavaScript, which is very light. Very light means very light. If your request is, I'm taking a very good example, like I have seen actually, like if you work on operating system or kernel, if someone is from is working on Linux, you can see that when whatever request you write and like whatever things you want to do on your system, so your request goes to the kernel and your request, it can be in any language, it can be whatever language you want, it can be Java, C sharp, Python. Okay, your request will be in few MBs or KBs, whatever how big your request is depends. Okay, then it gets converted in your machine language so that your kernel can understand, and then things get performed. Okay, so the conversion part, which kernel like machine language is a very light, it because why it is very light, because it has nothing to do, the compiler has nothing to do, whatever it has now, it has been converted to a language what your operating system is understanding. Okay, so the same way here the request has been converted to a language that browser is supporting, browser is understanding. Okay, if thing is that if you are passing a request to your browser and browser doesn't understand, now you need a compiler, so that will slow down your process. So the reason why Selenium is fast than other automation tool is this only. Its architecture is very strong and far, far better than what other automation tools architecture is. Okay, they actually go through the root directory of your browser and get the data out of it and then do the interaction. They do page modeling. Okay, we'll see what page modeling is in coming sessions. Okay, why it is slower than other automation tool and why it is faster. The reason why it is fast, because it actually request is actually getting passed in form of a JavaScript. Okay. So what Selenium Core is, it is actually the request which is getting passed from your server to the browser. Okay, and it injects into your browser and then your browser starts working. Then what is AOT? It's the application on which you will be doing testing. So it's not, it won't be a normal browser like it, the what Selenium RC will do, it will actually launch a separate web server. So what I told you, what things we can add here, what this server will do, I'll create a, I should write it in this way, this browser, one second. Okay, I'm not getting, okay. So this browser, this app browser which I have highlighted here is actually having a server and the application under test. So it will launch a server and it will launch the application on which the testing will be done. Okay. Then this server will actually send the request back to the RC server, which is a web server. Actually, I should say it's a web server, which is actually interacting with the browser, and then in this way the communication is done.